Good morning and welcome to Hope for the Family with Evangelist Noyantuni and Eden. God is good all the time. We bless God for keeping us alive to see this beautiful day which He has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. Shouts of victory and rejoicing are heard all the time in the tent of the righteous. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. That we have not become righteous with God through our own self-effort, amen, or human will. That God Himself chose us before the creation of the world, that we will be His children, amen, empowered by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to become the children of God. So we are rejoicing this day. We are thanking God for His faithfulness. He is our God. He will never fail us. Thank you for calling in today, my dear brother, Mr. Omashaye Amewero. God bless you and your family and your ministry. We thank God for His goodness to us this day. We have just about 16 or 17 minutes this day. This morning I'm starting a little bit late, but we pray that the Spirit of God will lead us, that at the end we'll be empowered to go out to represent God, to be ambassadors of God wherever we go today, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. There is power, what a working power in the name of our Lord. There is power, what a working power in the precious blood of Christ. There is power, wonder working power in the blood of our Lord. There is power, wonder working power in the precious blood of Jesus. Glory be to God. Father, as we have come before you today, we bow down our heads, for there is power in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power in the name of Jesus Christ, that name that you have given to us, the name that is above every other name. Every name must bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Jesus Christ is Lord. Father, we bless you. We have come today before you to obtain grace, to receive mercy, to help us in our times of need. We have come today, Father, Lord, to be fed, O Lord God, with your word, your living word that will produce, O Lord God, the fruit of righteousness in each one of us. Father, we bow our heads before you this morning, that our God. We acknowledge, Father, Lord, that you created us to be a holy people unto you, and we have sinned in so many ways. We ask for forgiveness as we plead the blood of Jesus Christ upon our ancestors, our families, our nations, our children, our husbands, the wives to your sons, O Lord God. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ upon the Church of Christ today, upon our Father's households, the household we are married into, upon the nations of the world. O God Almighty, help us this day. Forgive us of all our sins in the name of Jesus Christ. Our Father, as you are forgiving us, we release all that have sinned against us, for we know judgment without mercy will be shown to anyone that cannot forgive our brothers and sisters that have sinned against them. So we kneel at the cross of Calvary, the spirit of Cain, the spirit of jealousy in the life of Joseph's brothers that is still in our lives even today. With malice, bitterness, O Lord God, discrimination, tribalism, every work, O Lord God, that manifests in the flesh, O Lord God, that comes through the wisdom of this word, we nail to the cross of Calvary. Let heavenly wisdom continue to lead us, that we have your love in our hearts, our brothers and sisters, O Lord God, that we be people that are the truth, O Lord God, that uphold your word in everything that we do. People who proclaim your goodness to the world around us. People who encourage one another, building blocks, O Lord God, to build up your kingdom here on earth in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We thank you for what your spirit is doing in us and through us today. As we have come before you this morning, we bless you for the blood of Jesus Christ, that blood that works wonderful things for us. Through that blood, we have been redeemed, that we know that, and we are saying so, that we are your children, Jehovah God. Glory be to your name, our Father, in Jesus' mighty and precious name. We have prayed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May God be exalted in our midst today, in Jesus' mighty name. Before at the end of the session, we have about 5 minutes. We pray for the sick today. We lift up various situations in our families to God. We also pray for that, for the leaders and the body of Christ. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Psalm 91. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the foiler snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday.
1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you make the Most High your dwelling, even the Lord, who is my refuge, then no harm will befall you. No disaster will come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guide you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands, so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread upon the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. Amen. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Our God is faithful. We thank him for his love towards us. He has said that nothing can separate us from his love. We believe it, that God truly loves us, that he sent his Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to die for us, that he has shown us his salvation. If we believe in him, if we place our trust in him, if we acknowledge him before the world that is our God, he will protect us. Amen. He will give us power to trample upon snakes, scorpion, upon anything that we attempt to ever come against us. That we begin to open our mouths to speak as the oracle of God, commanding mountains to move, commanding indirect spirits to move, coming against the spirit of witchcraft and telling them straight in the face, in their faces, that you cannot stand against us, looking straight into their eyes and saying that we belong to God. We do not know you. You cannot manipulate us by your evil spells. You cannot control our minds. You cannot invoke any spirit against us and our households. We return upon the heads of all attempting to come against us. They are evil devices, because God is the God that breaks snares. He has broken every snare. For whom the Son of God sets free is free indeed. We are free from the curse of the law. We are free from the curse of tradition. We are free from household wickedness. We are free from spiritual wickedness in communities, in families. Even within the body of Christ, anyone attempting to penetrate into our relationships, anyone attempting to come against us, anyone holding any rod of oppression against us, let them hear the word of the living God, that they cannot come near us. There's no access into our families, into our lives, of any evil deeds, because we are the children of God. We know it and we are saying so. We stand on the foundation of God as given to us today, and we speak as the oracles of God against spiritual wickedness, that no wickedness can find any access into our dwelling places, for God encompasses around us. We uproot every device of the enemy on our jobs, in our communities, in the body of Christ, in the harvest streets, in our institutions. We uproot every devices of the wicked, those bringing drugs, those attempting to afflict our children with evil, those bringing depravity and sowing it in our schools. We uproot by the power of the living God those bringing pornography, those enticing children to run away from their families, those using our children in sex trade and child labor, those bringing bondage of drug addiction. We uproot by the power of the living God. We say our children are delivered. For the word of God says that when we lose anything near our earth, is lost in heaven. When we bound anything, is bound in heaven. In the name of Jesus Christ, we lose every knot tied against us and our families, against our children, not of barrenness, of lack of deprivation. We uproot by the power of the living God. We release the power of God upon us and our children today in the name of Jesus Christ. Power to go out into our institutions, to go out to acquire the education and skills they need to become responsible people, citizens of our nations and family. We uproot everyone bringing evil against us today. In vain they are gathered, they are swallowed in their own evil in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we bless you as we commit unto your hands today. Your children looking up to you for the blessing of the womb. Father, Lord, send forth your words, O Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ, to bless them this day. That husbands will be able to impregnate their wives will carry pregnancy to full term. Anything growing in the wombs of your daughters that should not be there, we uproot by the power of the living God. Oh God Almighty, protect the babies in their mother's wombs. Help your daughters to bring forth their babies into this world. We present to you the doctors, nurses, midwives, all that we attend to your children, they bring forth their babies, O Lord God. Jehovah God, we come against death and childbirth. We come against complications, O Lord God. We come against every utterance of the pit of hell. We frustrate darkness today in the name of Jesus Christ, that from the living life will come forth in the name of Jesus Christ. Get great miracles of God being done through birth in Jesus' mighty name. Father, for you have commanded the fruitfulness upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. We shall not die, but live to glorify our God. There will be no spiritual exchange is done. We rebuke you. We come against you, you household wickedness. We come against you, you negative voice. We come against you, every covenant taking according to the will of God. Every spiritual exchange blessing, Jesus, that will bring sorrow. We uproot by the power of the living God. Father, we bless you this morning. We thank you for children that we dedicated to you. We bless you that you make situations beautiful in our lives. You have called us by the names that we answer today. We are blessed by those names. We are members of our households. No one can invoke any spirit against our names. Any strange altars, we are names that we take into. We are pictures, items belonging to us and our families are taking to. Let the fire of the Holy Spirit descend upon those altars, bringing the altars, the priests, and those who took our names there down in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we bless you. We exalt your holy name. Any spirit, oh Lord God, conjured up anywhere from the sea in the name of Jesus Christ, from the forest, from the heavens, and from the desert in the name of Jesus Christ, from the ground, oh God, as we tread upon Jehovah God, from the air, we say, hear the word of God today. You do not prevail against us. We approach you by the power of the living God. We curse you, we bring you down in the name of Jesus Christ. You do not control us, or we are the children of the living God. God has commanded the blessings upon us. The only heavens that we have just read, that the sun, already the pestilence by day, shall not meet, shall not harm us, that the evil by noonday or the evil at night shall not come against our place, our dwelling places, cannot come against us. That we turn and with our eyes we shall see the reward of the wicked, the reward of God upon the wicked in the name of Jesus Christ. He's our God and rewards us for our good works. Already he himself polishes the evil forces of darkness with our evil works in the name of Jesus Christ. So now we say thank you for being our God who helps us. You are our God. You are our dwelling place, oh Lord God. We are resting in you today. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are the covering over our heads, oh Lord God. Father, send forth your word to heal those that are sick today, wherever they are today, in the hospitals, in the doctor's offices, the destitute on the street corners, oh Lord God, in our homes, in the rehabilitation centers, oh Lord God. Send forth your word, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ, your word that brings power, that brings life, that brings healing, that brings miracles, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ, that dying bones receive life, dying body organs receive life, memories being restored back by the power of the living God, in the name of Jesus Christ, internal organs attack, oh Lord God, receive life, in the name of Jesus Christ, oh God Almighty, in the name of Jesus Christ, move mightily on our behalf today, break the way, send forth miracles of healing, send forth miracles of life today, in the name of Jesus Christ, let the wind bring good success to us today, in the name of Jesus Christ, that the wind will blow every evil back into the ocean, in the name of Jesus Christ, that those that have dug a pit for us will fall into the pit they have dug with their own hands, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, make situations beautiful for us today, in our families, in our government, in the body of Christ, as we commit unto your hands, oh Lord God, leaders in our nations, oh Lord God, president of nations, oh Lord God, secretary of states, oh Lord God, mayors of towns and cities, councilmen and women, in the name of Jesus Christ, senators, congressmen, Jehovah God, everyone in position of leadership over us in our nations, oh Lord God, we pray that we begin to look up, that every wisdom will lead them in the things they do, that we'll take care of your children in our various communities. We come against every spirit that tempted to speak into our government. Father, you will be exalted in the government of the nations in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray this day that your children that you have chosen that will speak as our oracles will stand up and begin to march forward, begin to speak, begin to uproot spiritual wickedness, begin to reveal the work of darkness in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, use them mightily. Oh God Almighty, may they uplift the banner of Jesus Christ. May they not be afraid of men. Oh God Almighty, give them inner strength to prevail in every situation, that the rod of oppression will not be placed on the land you have given to us, oh Lord God, that your children will do good works in the name of Jesus Christ. We commit the body of Christ to you today, united in one spirit, one baptism, one Father, one Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, one hope of resurrection into eternal life. Jehovah everlasting God, arise today. Let the voices of false prophets and teachers within the house of God be silent. Let every lying spirit be pulled out by the power of the living God. We thank you for placing us in a rightful position within the body of Christ. May we be fruitful as we use our talents, oh Lord God, to bless the kingdom in Jesus' mighty name. Father, your house will always be a house of prayer to all nations, oh Lord God. The doors of the church will be open. Father, we come against all our God, buying and selling. In the name of Jesus Christ within the house, we overturn the tables of money changers, oh Lord God. Father, prevail in our midst. Holy Spirit, we invite you. Lord, help us in our worship, that we belong to those that worship our God in spirit and in truth. Teach us what it means to worship God in spirit and in truth. Help us, rebuke us, discipline us, enlighten our eyes to see. Help us to continue to build the kingdom. In the name of Jesus Christ, to preach this gospel with power in and out of season, that we continue to be prayerful. May the spirit of prayer descend upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. We come against every voice attempting to speak into the kingdom. We silence those voices today in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Father, we thank you for our spiritual fathers and mothers, the five-fold ministry, the council of elders and ministers. We present the congregation to you, Jehovah. Jehovah God. May the love of God be in our hearts, Lord God, for one another. In the name of Jesus Christ, may we not be those who send people away from the house of God. We pray that the church will continue to support the mission feet in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you, Lord of the harvest, for sending laborers out into the harvest field. We bless you, Jehovah God, and most souls will be brought into your kingdom. Bastardless will return, that this one will be preached with power in and out of season. We come against the persecuted church in Nigeria and around the world, Jehovah God. We pray, Jehovah God, that those persecuted are blessed and we inherit your kingdom. Hold back, oh Lord God, everything attending to come against your church, Father Lord. Prevail, oh Lord God, that the gate of hell will not prevail against the church of Christ in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we bless you. We thank you because we know in Jesus Christ we are victorious. We thank you, Jehovah God, because we know your word has implanted into our hearts, oh Lord God. We are established around our necks. We pull up, put the word and use it. We feed upon it. In the name of, we feed on it in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you this day, oh Lord God Almighty, for restoring to us and our families the things that belong to us, for disgracing those who came against us. We thank you for the marriage institution, a union between a man and a woman. We bless you, God Almighty. As we have received the tradition, we pass it on to our children. Our children will find rejoicing in their sex, oh Lord God. They will uphold the marriage institution. They will marry, live in their own homes, oh Lord God. Anyone invoke against our children, Father Lord, every cause preventing marriage from taking place, we overturn, we renounce. We speak to you, you darkness. We come against you as on wickedness. We come against the spirit of witchcraft. You cannot hold back our children. We trample upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. Every curse, every utterance over the head of anyone, or bringing banishment upon the heads of God's children from families, preventing them from settling down, we overturn by the power of the living God. That the word of God will prevail concerning his children, Jehovah God. We thank you, God Almighty. Your hands, Lord God, dwelling valiantly. Your right hand is highly exalted. Let your right hand uproot everything coming against us this day. Let your right hand deliver us from every plan of the enemy. Let your right hand establish your counsel concerning us today. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh God, we bless you for what you have done for us. There's no God as thee. We present to you those mourning the death of loved ones, those passing through challenges of life, oh Lord God. Father, send forth help, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Send forth comfort to your children mourning today in the name of Jesus Christ. For we are not the demonstration of things you created. When we die, we inherit your kingdom, Jehovah God. Father, you are God and ever. We bless you this morning. We thank you for the inner strength you have given to us to prevail in prayer today. Glory be to your name. Sweet of the living God, help us. Pray for us. We do not know how to pray. We do not know what we ought to pray about. We do not know the death of spiritual wickedness the enemy has attempted to bring against us. In our dream, the every human center, everything that is not of God, we overturn. We establish the will of God concerning us. In the name of Jesus Christ, we release the spirit of good success upon us and our families. In the name of Jesus Christ, we frustrate the kingdom of darkness today. We command you in the spirit, be that cast into the ocean. Move in the name of Jesus Christ. We command you, fig tree, barren fig tree, move in the name of Jesus Christ. We release upon us this day the almond tree blessing in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, we thank you. We bless our Father for what you know can do in us and what you have already done. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bless the God Almighty, that the Spirit is leading us today on the path that you have made for us and our families. Oh Spirit of the living God, we surrender to you. Have your way in our lives. Have your way in the lives of our children, our husbands, and the wives of God's children. Have your way in our father's house, all and the house we are married into. Have your way in our nations. In the name of Jesus Christ, Rehema Santa Nama Homo Shenda, uproot every spiritual wickedness. Rehema Santa Nama Homo Shenda, establish the counsel of God concerning us. As we go out today, by the means of every means of transportation we use today, by ever land, by sea, by the waterways, as we drive in our personal cars, as we go in public transportation, as we walk around our communities, keep us safe. In the name of Jesus Christ, uproot everything, put on roadside corner, tied in the air, let the wind blow and bring down every evil by the power of the living God, that the children of God will be delivered from every plan of the enemy. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we bless you. That our God and ever, our hands are lifted up to you in praise this morning for what you have done for us. You are God. Receive the praise and honor. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God. Be the rock of our salvation. Be exalted. Be God. Be exalted in our lives today in Jesus' mighty name. I thank you, my dear sister, Mrs. Esther Ayeto Adeni, for calling in this morning. God bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. What I will attempt to do, I'm really running. I have just about 6 minutes. Let me see. I want to read a little. I will just go back to something we have already read, just to remind us. Amen. Of the power of God to work. Amen. Acts chapter 2. The Holy Spirit comes at Pentecost. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly, it sounded like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues, and the Spirit enabled them. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. We pray that God Almighty will move mightily on our behalf, that we will be filled with the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ, and the Spirit will manifest in the whatever way God wants the Spirit to manifest in each one of us in Jesus' mighty name, that we receive power to preach the gospel, power to stand up on the foundation that God has set for us, to begin to proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. God does not delight in the death of a sinner. He's not slack about his promises. He's waiting for the entire world, all the nations of the world, all peoples, all tribes, all tongues, to hear about what he has done for us, that he has given us salvation in Jesus Christ. He has absolved us of all our sins, all our previous sins. Amen. That his light has come into this world, that the life of Jesus Christ is the light of men. It is for us to go out and proclaim this gospel. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. I thank God for my cousin, according to Ejiro, Ejiro Daniel Agambi, God bless you. Daniel Agambi, God bless you for calling in. God bless you and your family and your ministry. Glory be to God. This is as much as I can take this morning. Let us go out and believe that when we begin to walk with God, that God will come and indwell us. Let us be prayerful. Amen. The apostles were praying. They were praying when the Holy Spirit descended upon them. They added them to the word of Jesus Christ. They did not take it lightly. They remained in Jerusalem, waiting for the promised Holy Spirit. So let us wait and believe that the Spirit of the living God is leading us today, that the Spirit is right here. Amen. That will prevail over every situation when we continue to walk with our God. God bless you all. Have a wonderful day. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen.